How you doing? This is Dave from Airborne, and to all you French fans out there, keep supporting rock and roll, and we'll see you down at the show soon. Keep rocking. I think, you know, now that we've got a second album, we're touring, second album under our belt, it's definitely, with the extensive touring we've been doing of 2008 from Running Wild, and now it's definitely made us tighter as a band, and we've definitely developed over that process of making two albums now and touring and as a band. You know, it's just, I guess, just made us more of a machine, and I guess we're individually, we're more worldly, we're touring around, travelling in different countries, so just kind of, yeah, it's been great. Yeah, well, the first album, you have, you know, most of your life to write it, you know, in the early days, and then once it releases and start touring, you don't get time really to do much pre-production for the next album. So the first, yeah, Running Wild, we had a lot of stuff written down, we had a lot of time to do it, but No Guts, No Glory, we wrote a lot of stuff on the road over 2008, and then we went home to Warrnambool, our hometown back in Australia, and spent 4 months or so, or 5 months, pre-production. And so it was kind of like a break from the first tour, but a working break, you know, so we still did pre-production at the same time, then went to Chicago this time last year to record it, so that pretty much took up the majority of last year for, you know, No Guts, No Glory. So we just try to write on the road, hotels, in the bus, sound checks at shows and things like that, so, yeah. Well, it's better writing on the road when you're travelling around too, because you're more creative, because you're seeing different people every day. You meet, like, playing different towns, different venues, so lots of inspiration when you're travelling around.
And you get the energy of the audience.
Exactly, yeah. You're in a different mind frame. When you're back in your home area, you kind of, sometimes your mind can shut off, you know. And yeah, we never throw any ideas away. We always keep them in the rock bank, so to speak. So we'll always go back and review songs, and sometimes we might get stuck on a part of a song that's not working musically, and then we might take a bit out of another song and think, oh, that'll work there, you know. So we never throw anything away. We always just keep it there, and we may rework on it down the track. Like, I remember when we recorded Girls in Black on the Running Wild album, we dissected that song so many times, because there was bits that weren't working and bits that were, and we actually had other songs that were half made, and we ripped bits out of that and put it into that, and then voila, that's what it is today. So yeah, no, we always keep as many ideas as we can, and no, we might even re-release some of the ones off our EP we did maybe down the track, Ready to Rock. We might even redo some of those and put them on an album. That's on the cards as well.
Yeah.
No, we're not getting lazy. No, we, you know, we like the... I guess, yeah, there is a few more mid-tempos on this, but we kind of... I guess with songs like Blonde, Bad and Beautiful and Bottom of the Well, they're different style songs for Airborne. You know, we love playing the Born the Kills and the Raise the Flags and the, you know, and the Blackjack kind of songs on stage. They're the funnest to play, but I guess, you know, we try to just... Yeah, I don't know, we didn't really plan on that. We try to do a handful of mid-tempos and a whole heap of fast rockers as well, but that's just the way it panned out, you know. It might be the complete opposite on the next album. But, you know, you do have to have a few of your slow mid-tempos in there as well, just to, you know, they're the ones that kind of get on, you know, radio and become a hit or something like that, so they're great, you know, and radio is very helpful for breaking your band, so it's, yeah, that's just the way it kind of panned out for this album. Yeah, well, we were a bit, I mean, yeah, I guess in the studio we are our own critics at the same time, and if we do, sometimes we go, yeah, no, these are feeling a bit slow here, we have to make sure we put some fast ones in here, because that's what we're about, you know, but I guess we'll just have to watch out on the next album and put an extra couple of fast ones in. No, we're all a tight unit. Well, Joel's the main lyricist, he writes the majority of the music, but when it comes to the music side of things, we all just come together, you know, we all are open to put riffs, you know, bring ideas to the table, and I'll even record riffs down or whatever, and then we just kind of put it together all in the rehearsal room. We're like a bunch of brothers, really. We all get along really good together, it works really. Everyone knows their job in the band in and out, so when it comes to the studio or whatnot, we all just collaborate together things work sometimes, things don't work, so yeah, it's a good system. Oh, just playing shows every night, yeah, pretty much. It's especially when you're doing your own tours, like when we just come through Europe earlier on in the year, we're doing an hour and a half shows, it is a high energy show, so to keep that up for an hour and a half keeps you pretty fit, and then just doing that every night keeps you fit. But I guess, you know, we drink a lot as well, and not that that's a good thing, but you've got to be careful on the road. You can get run down pretty quick, you know, if you're getting drunk all the time, it can take its toll, but we pick our fights, you know. We love to just get up and have a great show and then have a few beers after, and then do it all again the next day, so yeah. But I know, it's I guess we're all young at the moment, it might be hard when we're 40, but Well, I don't know. Well, you look at Mick Jagger. Look at Aerosmith. We just played with them the other day. I don't know how old they are now, but they're still unreal on stage. They look like they're in their prime still, so it'd be great to be able to still do that at their age. French audience is wild audience. It's a great. We love coming to France. It's, we just did a signing session before, and it was just packed with lots of our fans, and they're just... You can just feel the energy coming off and they're pumped for today's show. I can't wait to get on stage, actually. So, and you guys just really love rock and roll. You really support rock and roll and just get behind the bands. And it's great. You know, this is a really good market for us here in France. It's really great. We love coming through here. Yeah, it has moved up kind of quick, yeah. And we love the food and French wine, so it's all good. Slash is playing after us, I think. We've been playing a few festivals with him, so I wouldn't mind watching him again, because it's a great band what he's got going at the moment. And Twisted Sister I've never seen, and Alice Cooper I haven't seen him either, so I'd love to get up there and watch them.